Anyways, oh my God, she actually does it. Get him, Juno. I can't believe it. It is so horrific. I don't even want to show you. That's just wrong. Women, don't go taking lessons from Lorena Bobbitt now. I mean, that's just wrong, people. You don't. That's. No. No. I mean, I don't even know what to say to a scene like that. I mean, what can you possibly say to relieve the tension after a scene like that?
Help. Teenager cut my balls off, call the police.
Okay. All right, that actually works. That's good. That's a good one. I really shouldn't be laughing at this. So Haley, after all that hard work, decides that she needs to take a shower before she cleans up and leaves. She needs to take a shower. I need to take a shower after that scene. That's just dirty. And while she's taking a shower, Jeff miraculously finally gets free, just in time. Gets up and immediately checks that private area that we all know you should check after a fucked up situation like that. And guess what? He's still intact. Right on, right on. You imagine he does. He fucking grabs his gun and starts to sneak up on Haley while she's in the shower. Only, surprise, surprise, she's not actually in the shower. And she sneaks up behind him and taser his ass. So anyways, after she electrically shocks him to the point that he passes out, she is somehow able to lift him up onto a chair in an elaborate hanging contraption. I mean, seriously, this girl's like the female Jigsaw. Oh my God! Haley grows up and becomes Amanda! I knew it! I fucking knew it! But luckily, he doesn't actually do that, and we're treated to the finale. Thank God. In which he actually goes apeshit insane in the midst of his guilt, and we're treated to these lovely moments.
What took you so long?
You dropped this.
Oh, I had to.
Yeah.
Or else you would have been down there forever. What were you doing? Jerk it off?
Which do you want to fuck first, me or the knife? You know how to use that, huh?
Honor student, remember?
Oh, good for you!
Find it, Jeff. No. Jeff, she's gonna find it all. Put on the noose. Put on the noose and jump, and I'll stop it. She'll never find out. She'll just think you were some sad man. Some sad man who she never should have left. Jeff?
Butter. Smack her. Throw off the roof. Do something. You're no longer tied to the chair, man. You're 30 years old. I'm pretty sure you can overpower a 14-year-old girl. Although, in Juno's defense, it's not like pedophiles are the hardest criminal minds to take down. Chris Matthews does it all the time, so maybe, I don't know.
I didn't kill her. I just watched. I wanted to take pictures. But he wouldn't let me. Gives me another guy. I didn't do it, I swear. I'll tell you his name. And I hope you find him. I hope you find him.
I know his name. I know his name. Jeff. You know, it's funny. Aaron told me you did it before he killed himself.
It was him, it wasn't me.
I don't care. I promise. I'll take care of it all.
It's a trap!
Told you. God. So that was Hard Candy. The ending was a little overdramatic and kind of silly. But other than that, it was an okay movie. I really enjoyed the first two-thirds of it. I really liked some of the moral ambiguity of the movie, and I think it's a very thought-provoking film, but it just... I felt like there was nobody to root for, you know? I mean, Jeff's a pedophile. It's pretty clear by the end of the movie he's a pedophile. And Haley's a psychopathic bitch, so it's like, who's the good guy in this situation? Who do I root for? And with nobody to root for, that doesn't really build any tension. And with no tension, a movie that's supposed to be a thriller isn't really that thrilling. The first two halves, you know, Act 1 and Act 2, when we're introduced to the characters and you know, when Haley really starts doing some of the things she does, like I said, there are things you're just sitting there watching the movie and you're like, maybe Jeff's not what she, you know, you think he is. Maybe Haley's got it all wrong. But, you know, like I said, by the end of the movie, it's pretty clear that he is exactly what Haley thinks he is. And by the end of the movie, you pretty much know that Haley, he isn't the first pedophile she's killed, so you know she's got a track record. And I guess the real question you gotta ask yourself is, do two wrongs make a right? I mean, do you honestly think that Haley is morally justified in her actions if you honestly believe that she can stop at just killing two pedophiles? And what happens when she keeps growing? You know, she gets older and we, you know, maybe her judgment won't always be spot on. Maybe, you know, she'll, maybe one day she might get to a guy who really was innocent, and then what? She's no different than any other murderer. So, I don't know. I guess I just feel like, you know, two wrongs don't make a right to me. Just because you think that you're morally just in what you're doing does not make it right. And almost every evil act in history, I think, has started with that notion that it's okay to do what we're doing because these people are lesser than us, or these people are, you know, morally inferior to us, or something along that lines. Like I said, it's a thought-provoking film, but it's not a great movie. And it isn't a movie that I think is thrilling or horrifying. There is that one great scene, the fake castration scene, but that's one moment. And, you know, one moment of tension doesn't make a good thriller. Well, yeah, you know, Hard Candy. Check it out if you're interested. Watch it if you really want to see a pedophile get tortured for an hour and a half. That's not really my cup of tea. So I didn't really love it, didn't really hate it. It was an okay movie. And I got some comedy out of it. So, yeah, Hard Candy. I'll give it, as far as spill ratings go, a rental. A solid rental. It's not a movie you have to own. It's not a movie you have to buy. It's a movie you really only need to watch once. The performances are fantastic. Acting-wise, it's beautiful. The cinematography is very lovely to watch. The color pattern and the schemes are great. And like I said, it will leave you thinking. And I always give a movie extra points for making me think. It's just, like I said, as far as a thriller goes, it's not very thrilling. And that's... it's one Achilles heel, and it's one of the reasons why I won't give it a matinee or full price. You know, if you make a thriller, I expect to be thrilled, and I wasn't thrilled, so I'm sorry. Anyways, this has been Benjamin David for the Weekenders Group with my first video review, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And just want to give a special thanks to Guy Behind the Guy and B. Diddy for creating this Weekenders Group. It's my personal favorite group on Spill. And other than that, peace.